There's three things that you have to do if you're trying to recover from an affair. Number one, we focus on your marital recovery. So we're putting the proper building blocks in place to ensure that you have a solid foundation for a great marriage. Number two, we focus on your individual recovery process, because the pain and the experience of the hurt partner, is different than the pain and the experience of the unfaithful partner. So while the unfaithful partner is dealing with, how do I honor my marriage? How do I become faithful again? How do I overcome the temptations of opposite sex members? The hurt partner is dealing with, how do I forgive? How do I trust again? How do I heal my heart? How do I begin to rekindle sexually? So by focusing on the marital recovery and the individual recovery process, we're able to make a quantum leap forward in their success as a couple. The third piece is we focus on the affair recovery process. Most counselors don't even touch the affair. They rather not deal with it. They rather just talk about the marriage. But if you don't deal with the hard issues that you've just endured, they're bound to creep up and happen again. So there are six stages of the affair recovery process. The first stage is the discovery phase. That's when you first find out about the affair. The second stage is the disclosure phase. That's when you share all of the details of the affair that
you
happened.
Share everything.
Everything. You have to share everything. I'm gonna tell you why. Oftentimes the hurt partner can't move forward. They cannot heal. And so while the unfaithful partner just wants to move forward with life and hope that one day the wife or the husband will get over it, the hurt partner is trapped in their mind. And because they don't have all of the details of what has happened, you're forcing their imagination to run wild. And oftentimes their imagination of what happened is far worse than the actual details that you could reveal. So when you share all of the components of what has happened in that affair, it gives that hurt partner a sense of closure. Now, the truth hurts, but the truth also heals. And so many hurt partners have said, you know what? As bad as what you did was, what hurt more is the fact that you've denied the truth from me for so long. So when we're able to go through that discovery and that disclosure phase, then we can enter into the why of the affair. Because if you don't know why the affair occurred in the first place, then it's bound to happen again. So we've got to dig deep inside of the roots of what has occurred, psychoanalyze that thing, and put up building blocks and walls of protection to keep it from happening again. Then we go through the forgiveness phase. Then we go through the trust building phase, and finally we go through the rekindling phase of love and intimacy within that relationship. Now you have a foundation for a sustainable relationship.
Ooh, that's amazing. But you know, this even, you know, makes me think, how does one prevent infidelity? How? Like, what are the major things couples need to do?
The biggest question that singles ask is, can men and women really just be friends? The biggest questions that couples ask is, can really men and women just be friends? So there's a whole lot of confusion about this opposite sex friendship. And oftentimes when you really think about it, most affairs occur with a quote unquote friend, someone who I work with, who I see every day, someone who I serve in ministry with, someone who I see at the gym every time I go. And we form some type of rapport, some type of relationship. And because we don't have proper boundaries that we've established for the marriage, now it can lead into an affair. Let me just say this. Every single relationship on the planet Earth, whether you're dealing with a male-male, a female-female, or a male-female, every single relationship is based upon some form of attraction. Now, it may not be physical, it may not be emotional, it may not be sexual, but there's something that draws you to that person. Maybe you have shared interests, maybe you have shared likes and hobbies, and that attracts you to that person. And over the course of time, you begin to develop a platonic relationship with them. Now, when you look up the word platonic, it's problematic all within the definition. Because according to the definition of platonic, it is defined as to have an intimate and affectionate relationship void of sex. Now, if truth be told, I can't be too intimate and affectionate with you without there being some sexual energy that will eventually form as a result of our interaction. And so what is platonic can soon become problematic. And we have to learn how to establish clear boundaries, right? And laws and rules of what is appropriate opposite sex relationships to have so it doesn't negatively impact the integrity of the marriage.
Wow, that's amazing.